I already introduced you to Layers palette and some features, and you know that it displays all layers in the active document, as well as any effects applied to the image. So now we'll go over some other options and commands. At the top of the palette, you can set the layer blending mode. By default, it's normal. Any other mode will change how the image interacting with layers below. You can see that as soon as I change the top layer mode from normal, I no longer have a solid image. It appears depends on the blend I choose and the layers below it. Next to the blending modes is Opacity. This function allows you to set layers transparency. I often use it to show see-through materials. Lock commands allow you to protect the layer from all or specific editing. If you recall from the toolbox section, I locked transparency to use eraser so that it would cover parts of the image using background color instead of deleting pixels completely. Whenever you use protection commands, padlock appears on the respective layer. To unlock, first make sure that layer is selected and then click on highlighted icon. You could see that padlock disappears. In addition to transparency, you can lock image pixels. That will allow you to move the layer, but will protect it from any editing, like drawing, or deleting. Lock position does the opposite of image pixels. It allows you to draw, fill and delete, but it won't let you to move your layer around. And finally, lock all. We'll protect your layer from any kind of editing. At the bottom of the palette is a number of basic commands, which allows you to delete layer, create a new one, which is always transparent, and you can also use this icon to duplicate a layer. To do so, just click on the layer and drag it directly to the icon. And it will copy layer, its effect and properties. You could see that I got background copy 2 with opacity 73 and all the effects listed below. The next icon allows you to create a group where you can place your layers. It's a handy feature if you have a number of layers creating one image. For example, you have a presentation board just like this one. I have quite a few layers here. This is my source document, and I prefer to have every image on the separate layer for easy editing, like changing background, for example. Changing stacking order, just click and drag to the desired location. Remove items I don't want, or deciding which color tank top to use in styling. The only problem is moving things around. For example, I want to move my styled croquis. To do that, I would have to select the croquis layer, its hair. For Windows, hold Ctrl key and click on the layers you want to select. shoes, pants, basically the entire outfit, including hidden layers, in case I change my mind. And only now I can move the entire style croquis. So you can imagine how happy I was when Adobe Photoshop offered grouping. To group, simply click and drag your selected layers directly into the new group icon. And Adobe Photoshop will place all your layers into one folder. Now I can move, hide, lock, or delete. And I still can work on each layer individually. Another way to create a group from selected layers is to go to the palette menu and choose new group from layers. It is always a good idea to give them a name. And just click OK. And finally, simply click on the icon Create a New Group and drag the layers inside the folder. If you wish to remove a layer from the group, just click and drag it outside. If you wish to separate layers, just right-click on the respective group and choose Ungroup Layers. Now, if you have only a couple of layers that you wish to move around together, you can use Link command. First, let's select the layers and click Link. Now you could see the title of my presentation board and the graphic image are moving together. One of the differences between grouping and linking is a stacking order. When you link layers, the layer's position in the palette doesn't change. Grouping, on the other hand, will push layers together, producing undesired results. As you could see, stacking order is very important. In addition to linking layers, you can link pretty much anything together, like groups, or a group and a layer. And to unlink, just simply click on the icon again. Next to the link is an Add Layer Style icon. We covered it in the Styles palette section. Just to remind you, it allows you to style your layer. If you don't wish to have so many layers, and you want to have some of them as one image, Adobe Photoshop offers a number of ways to merge layers. You can choose to merge down or merge visible, to merge layers from selection, simply choose Merge Layers. You can also right-click to access these options. Bear in mind that merging is very different from grouping, where you can simply put all the layers in one folder and then ungroup them if you choose so. Merging combines all the pixels from all the layers, permanently overwriting pixels from the bottom layer with pixels from the top layer, and they cannot be unmerged. Let me give you an example. Right now I have a graphic and two tank tops on separate layers. I can choose to move or remove the graphic. I can hide tank top effects, and I can also choose one or the other tank top to go with the graphic. Once I merge the graphic layer, let's say with a blue tank top, right click, select Merge Layers. These options are no longer available. Graphic, tank top, and its effect became one image. And if I were to delete the graphic, let's say using Magic Eraser, I'm left with destroyed tank top. Now, that would not have happened if I have all the images on the separate layers. The only way to remove merge command is to undo using History Palette. And finally, you can flatten the entire image. When you do so, Adobe Photoshop asks you if you want to discard hidden layers. If you recall, I have quite a few hidden layers, like a jacket or pink tank top. If I click Cancel, I'll just go back to my previous state and I would need to unhide hidden layers. In this case, I'm happy with the way image looks, so I'll just go into click OK. And we have only one layer. Now, flattening the image not only merges layers permanently, rendering all the effects, but it also replaces transparency with white color and partially locks the layer, converting it into background. To sum it all up, most commonly used layers, commands, and features are displayed at the top and the bottom of the palette. Double-click on the layer for layer style window. If you double-click on the group, you can access group properties, where you can assign it a proper name. You can also double-click directly on the text to rename. For the list of features, either right-click on the layer or go to the Layer Palette menu, as well as the Layer Menu command at the top bar. Notice that the same command is listed in more than one place. And before you do any kind of editing to the layer or the group, make sure it's selected.